Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to develop locally BlackSheep. So the first thing to do is to have installed Python version, which is supported, which can be one of the supported versions, and a C compiler, which is required by Cython. And of course, in this video I'm using Git. So you can clone the repository from GitHub. In this case, I already prepared a demo folder for this demo. And since I like lowercase folder names, I will just specify this name. Of course, it's optional. I cd into this folder. And here, what I can do, I can create a Python virtual environment. So I'm using virtual environment module, and I'm creating a folder called virtualenv, venv. Then I activate the virtual environment. And install dependencies. So pip install the requirements.txt file contains all dependencies also for testing. So it contains more dependencies than the setup PI file. Here I'm under Ubuntu, where HTTP tools is supported, but BlackSheep will work also under Windows. It is also tested under Windows by GitHub workflows. Here pip is recommending to upgrade it. And I did it, it's optional. So now I have Cython installed and I can compile. If you can use the make file, do make compile. To compile the C code, the Cython extensions. Takes a few seconds. Once this is done, I can already start the test and see if the tests are passing on my local computer. Okay, so I do clear to clear my screen. And here, as I said, I can do test. I can run the test. So in the BlackSheep repository, there are two folders for tests. One is called iTest, which is for integration tests, which are slow because they start an application server in memory. And one folder is called tests, which is for a unit test, which complete rapidly. So in this case, if I want to run only the speed, the fast ones, can do pytest test, and you can see in about 6 seconds it will, 7 seconds actually, but it ran 1201 tests. If I want to run the test including the slow one, I can simply write pytest. And that's it. And if you want to see the code coverage, you can do make test code or run directly the command if make is not available on your system. So run directly the command under test code to see it, to see the same result. And now I have an HTML coverage file where I can see the coverage of the test, which is 100%. That's it. Thank you.